when we went from bipolar to CMOS, we thought our thermal problems were over because we had ECL dissipating huge amounts of power, drawing huge amounts of current, to this CMOS, which just sips. And so initially they said, oh, you thermal guys, we don't need you anymore. A couple years later, and we have a billion transistors on a chip. And so when you look at that, there's a lot of power. And we have different kinds of problems than we had with ECL and with bipolar. Everything's getting smaller. I mean, you always have more than one device in a system. And so you have to balance between those devices. And junction temperatures are what we use to find the worst case condition. Usually we don't want to operate at these conditions, but having a limit for that is very important. Now, for instance, for most CMOS devices, 125 degrees junction temperature is the maximum. However, with things like memory, it's more like 85 degrees. The issues that pop up are leakage. As we get smaller and smaller in devices, more and more leakage affects the signals. As we drop our operating voltages, more current comes in. So if you go from 5 volts to 3.3, you've almost doubled the current for the same amount of energy that you're putting in there. So generally in a consumer goods, say a set-top box, there's not as much pressure, so you keep about 100 degree junction temperature, you'll probably be okay. It also has to do with reliability, electromigration. Higher the temperature, the old rule of thumb is 10 degrees is you double the activation energy, and that means that things are going to fail that much faster. So mitigating those with lower temperatures is what we try to do. And on the other side of it, you don't want to do overkill. You don't want to put a $50 heat sink on a $10 part, even though it's dissipating a lot of power. You have to find a reasonable trade-off between cost and performance in everything you do. And that's where programs like Simcenter FLOEFD integrated into the workforce just make things flow better. And you can look up front and try scenarios. Say, what if this? What if? And you can put a $50 heat sink on it and show them that it doesn't work that much better than a $10 heat sink. So it really helps with the manufacturing also. What can be manufactured, standard materials, and cost overall, because cost is king. Doesn't matter how exotic the part is, the cost is going to dictate the schedule and the final product.